Okay, so now that I have the pieces attached and everything, and I went ahead and hemmed my top row edges, I want to tackle the tie straps. Now, remember those excess pieces we cut away when we were making everything even? I'm actually going to use that as a template because the width of it is actually ideal, but the length of it is not. So I'm going to use it as a template to make a bigger version of it and use the extra pieces of fabric that I have here to create it. So I'm just going to use it as a template, mark off the points, take my ruler, and create a bigger version of it. And that's all. Make sure you're working with the right side of your top, all right? So what you're gonna do is just take those tie straps that you just cut out and just do what you see I'm doing here. Take the right side of the tie strap, lay it on the right side of the top, and make sure you're placing the tie strap from the top of the piece. Once you have everything in place, just pin it, and then you just do the same for the other side and take it to the machine. Okay, so for this part, you want to make sure that you're working on the wrong side. In other words, it's like if you're turning the top inside out, right? Because we're gonna attach and close off the front. What you want to do is make sure that everything is even. So when you fold it in half, make sure that everything is nice and even. Take some pins and pin the front in place. You're gonna stop right where your tie straps end. Right? Just like what you're seeing here. Okay, before you get into the nitty-gritty of this part, try on your completed piece so far. This way, you can identify where you need to attach your spaghetti straps or shoulder straps, whatever you want to call it. So just do that. Identify where your straps are going to be attached in the front and in the back, and take it off, pin the straps in place, take it to the machine, and completed top inside out now. Once you've done that, make sure the front of your top is facing upward. You're gonna now take your pants and place it inside of the top. Make sure your pants is turned right side out and the front of your pants is facing upward. Once you've done all of that, just place the pants inside of your top, line up your top front seam to the pants front seam, pin that in place, and do the same for the back seams and the two side seams. Once you have everything pinned in place, you can now take it to your machine and run a stitch. Just make sure when you're running your stitch to pull and stretch your pants waist while you're stitching. This is to ensure that nothing snaps and bursts on you when you actually put in on the clothes.